I'm Daryl Braithwaite, and welcome to Dreams Can Come True. We're here in Eden on the southern New South Wales coast, actually in this magical valley, a short distance inland from that famous whaling port. This is beautiful country, rolling green hills, flowing rivers. And it's here, in the lap of paradise, the little girl by the name of Erin Hallinan was born 16 years ago, in a valley just over that ridge. Erin's life changed forever 4 years ago, when she was diagnosed with leukemia. She hasn't been home much since then, and well, she's doing it tough right now. When we heard of Erin's plight, we asked her what she wanted most in the world. If she could go anywhere or do anything, we'd try our hardest to make her dream come true. And you know what Erin's dream was? To come home.
On a hill in the bush near a river that's beautiful, and it's like the Garden of Eden. I miss home a lot because of having to sleep in my own bed, which is comfortable, and all the hospital beds are hard and horrible. I miss my friends and going to school sometimes. All the fences are down and the cow walked in the house. Yeah, I think the house has fallen down a little bit. It doesn't matter because that's my home.
I could honestly say to you, it's Erin's dream to go home. She wants to be with her friends and kick the dogs and scruff the cats and live the life that she lived before she got sick.
You like to see your children grow up and have a decent childhood, to be able to, for them to have children as well. She's the strongest person I know.
Well, this time around, it's been 7 months of chemotherapy in Sydney Hospital since Erin and her parents, John and Linda, last saw home. As you can see, things are really run down.
The generator's not working, the roof's on its last legs, Linda's prized garden has ended up lunch for the cows, who have also made a meal of the old fences and the furniture inside. For Erin to be able to return home, this place is going to need a lot of work. Because John and Linda are fighting this cancer alongside their daughter, the family's finances have gradually been eaten away.
I was 11 years old when it all happened. It's been on hard, Mum and Dad. Our lives have changed like heaps because we've had to stay up in Sydney for ages, and that means like we can't go home and maintenance on the house and that, and it's all old and fallen down. My one wish is to go home and stay at home and not having to come up to the hospital anymore. I'm a fighter because I want to get through it. I want to have a happy life and have kids. It gives me lots of hope and that I know I'll get through it because I've come this far, so I might as well go the rest of the way.
That's Erin's dream, to come home. But how to make it happen? Well, just ask the people of Eden and they'll tell you.
Better music and more of it. 2EC.
Singer Daryl Braithwaite will be leading the celebrations to welcome young Eden girl Erin Hallinan home this Sunday. So, a huge working bee has been organised for this weekend, and many people and companies have rallied to make Erin's dream come true. Minor 10 have donated all of the building materials. Harvey Norman have supplied new furnishings and Solarex a new power system. But it's really the local community who have opened its heart, donating labour, supplies and whatever is needed to get the job done. Thanks so much to people like Hazelton Airlines, JD Video, Master Hire, Towns Haulage, Edwards Bus Company, The Magnet, Eden Nursery, The Lioness Club, The Cancer Society, even the local stores like The Butchers, The Deli, The Bakery, The Pub. Just about everyone has given so much to make Erin's dream come true. So a big thank you to each and every one of you.
After 8 months away, Erin is finally on her long journey home. A little anxious and a little nervous, but also very glad to be back. And completely unaware of the huge surprise she has waiting for her at home.
Good, how are you?
Great!
How are you?
Wow,
you!
Little gate over there.
Home sweet home, mate. Oh, look at this.
Oh, bit of a difference.
Oh, yeah. This is a mansion!
It's amazing, yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, let's have a look around, Erin.
Oh, no!
It's just, well, I did cry and I had to walk inside because I'm not a wimp, but I had tears in my eyes because it was just, like you say, overwhelming. The whole community just come together for Erin's sake. Well, it gives you faith back in mankind again.
Oh,
Good girls toilet.
You stove with a
gorilla.
Like a gorilla at long last.
Or just compact it down under the bed, sure.
It's taken just 48 hours for the community to transform Erin's beloved but ramshackle house into a dream home. Re-roofed, re-plumbed, rewired, painted, carpeted, furnished, new ceilings in every room. 2 days, $60,000 and a million good wishes. Erin was finally back where she belonged. Thanks to her friends and supporters, Erin was home.